Hello everybody, this is the Praetorian. I'm doing my 10 a.m. video, and I have actually got something good to talk about today. I've been doing my other series about socialism at 10 p.m. and I came across something that made me really stop and think about the idea that everybody has when it comes to borders and countries and stuff, about the principle of self-determination. You know, I've actually got my opinion about that, and the one thing that I've realized is, you know, ever since World War One, we've had these countries that have pretty much used the principle of self-determination to get away with a lot of things. If you stop and you look at it, whenever World War One was over and Germany and Austria and all those countries had to give up land, the German people were actually, you know, cast into areas that were governed by Czechoslovakia and the Italians, and they caused a lot of upheaval, you know. And at the same time, these other countries use the same concept, you know, the same principle for self-determination to create and break down countries between themselves and Russia and Germany in order to supposedly protect themselves, you know. I see the same thing happening when it comes to the Middle East, you know, when it comes to today and trying to make a change for the better in our world. I think that we need to stop practicing these crazy theories that, you know, are just completely ridiculous. You take a look at a lot of the map when it comes to Europe and it comes to the Middle East, all right? And then you look at just where we know the CIA, for example, is active at. Okay, we know that the CIA is active in Ukraine. We know that they're active in Turkey. We know that they're active in Azerbaijan. And we know that they have been active in Iraq, possibly Syria too. Then you look at all the chaos that's going on in that region. You've got the chaos going on in the UK. You got chaos going on in Turkey. The PKK is actually working through Azerbaijan to commit terrorist acts. And we look the other way because they are helping us out in northern Iraq and fighting against ISIS in Iraq and Syria. But why is all this possible, and how is it that there's so much turmoil in these areas? If you go back in history and you look at that, I mean, this was back when the original reason for why the Muslims have such a big problem against, you know, the United Nations is the fact that England didn't actually, you know, respect the boundaries within that area. They came in and they just split all this region up into their own maps and determined that this was going to be a country, this was going to be a country, that was going to be a country, and that's all there was to it. Palestine went from being Palestine to being Turkey, Syria, Iraq, Jordan, Israel, you know, and Egypt and things like that. that's really what started a lot of that. And then you take a look at Europe, it was the same way. Whenever they turn around and they split Germany up, and Hungary and Austria, they created smaller states within the European areas. You know, you've got, now it's called Czechia, but it used to be Czechoslovakia. You have Austria, you got Hungary, you got Slovakia, Slovenia, Croatia, Bosnia, Herzegovina, Serbia. You know, you have all these areas that are completely just broken down into little bitty areas, and it's just insane. I think that's an issue, you know, that a lot of people need to look at. Here in the United States, I think when I look at that, I look at the same issue that we have when it comes to voting. Here in Illinois, the majority of the state, from everything I've ever seen, is all red. It's Republican. The majority of the state is a Republican state. But on a national level, if you're not here in the United States, or if you're not here in the state of Illinois, and you're not paying attention, you don't pick up on that. You know, they tell you that Illinois is a Democrat state. Well, look at the voting areas. There's more Republican areas in Illinois than what there is Democrat. But when you start getting into the Chicago area, that's when all of the voting areas get broken down, and they're smaller areas, and they're breaking it down to where Chicago has more power than the rest of the state. So everything that happens in Illinois gets dictated through Chicago. You know, that's the weirdest part about that, is it all does make sense when you look at it in that point of view. And it's just, when I see that, it just makes me stop and think about it. You know, for any kind of real change to go on, I think that issues like that need to be sorted out, and they need to be taken care of. And it all comes back to what I was saying before, you know, with socialism, that's what these people like to do. They like to break things down into create freaking statistics and polls and percentages and things like that to where it benefits, you know, them, benefits their agenda and what they want everybody to see and hear and believe. You know, we've got things going on today that are just insane. We have people protesting over a president, you know, that they don't agree with. Okay, so how many times have we had bad presidents, you know, that people didn't like? It's completely ridiculous. And for anyone to think that this is just a spur-of-the-moment thing, that's crazy, right? Tell me that there isn't a force behind that that's organizing it and creating the chaos. You know, another thing that I noticed last night, whenever I was going through what I'm going through right now, is actually about Czechoslovakia. It's about the first president of Czechoslovakia. He was actually socialist, and he was pretty crazy about a lot of things. If you guys don't know who I'm talking about, I'm talking about Tomas Masaryk. And the thing that I've been picking up on there is about subversion. You know, how he was actually committing subversion in his own country against his own people when it came to sovereignty and their beliefs and stuff. You know, before that election, you had, people getting on ABC News and having cameras secretly filming old people in restaurants being prejudiced. And today, that's just completely forgotten. Nobody remembers that, but they'll sit there and they'll start race baiting and trying to say that you're wrong because of the color of your skin. But they were the ones doing it first. They're the ones that instigated all that. You turn around and you see things like that, and then you see people actually subverting our country by attacking our beliefs, nitpicking through what people thought was the truth forever, and then these people come along and say, "Nope, that's not the facts. This is actually what happens." And it's because they're literally attacking your beliefs. They're attacking what you believe is patriotic or anything like that. That's why they're taking down statues in the South, because they're attacking your belief systems. They attack the Confederate flag. The list goes on. And it's all because they're subverting your cult, our culture. And then you take another one, for example, about subversion. These people are literally going and they're attacking our sovereignty and using equality as a way of doing it, Okay, the thing of it is that we got to realize is our sovereignty is means that they're attacking each and every one of us. Me, you, everybody. And the reason why is because the sovereignty of this country is you, me, and everybody else. That's what it is. And see, with socialism, everything has to be easy and it's got to be manageable. And with each of us, we have different opinions and different ways of thinking. So that can't be part of anything, because what they've got to do is they've got to be able to make decisions and it's got to be good, and you complicate the issues, so you have to be taken out of the equation. How do you do that? You get rid of constitutional law, you get rid of constitutional government, you create a socialist government, and how do you do that? You subvert. We've got people sitting there attacking freaking police officers now too. It's just insane. This stuff cannot just be happening off the spur of the moment. There has to be a driving force behind it. And I think it's time that most of us start figuring that out and pulling our heads out of our ass and actually making a change. It's time for the old shit to stop. We need to come up with new ways of handling stuff. Well, I did my morning rant. I am still behind on everything, but I'm catching up on it. I will talk to you guys later, and I hope you enjoy this. Oh, by the way, I got my new background video on here, so tell me if you want to, if you'll like it. Until next time, bye.